Salut les amis, hello folks. We are with the legend Christian.
Legend.
Legend who won Just Biking Man X. And I just wanted to chat with Christian about his bike configuration so that he can share what he has used, because you've been doing 6 Biking Man already?
Yes, and pretty much the same configuration of the bike.
So that's the perfect timing to interview Christian. Tell me more about your bike.
So my bike is, the call name is Farah. Is a small company by bike. It's a handmade in Norway.
Okay.
And the CEO is my friend, is a very good cyclist too, Jeff Webb.
With whom you raced.
Yes. He introduced me in the world of the ultra cycling. And so we still we continue our collaboration. I testing his bike wherever in the world, and I think this is perfect bike for the ultra race, because it's the right combination. It's not gravel, it's not aero, it's in the middle. We call a bike for all road. You can put the wire tire, more than 32. Is not very, the angle is not very high, so it's more relaxed bike. It's not a very sprint bike. And my configuration bike is pretty much the same of all other ultra race. That is my, I am feeling good with this kind of configuration.
So you've been to Portugal, Taiwan,
I've been in Portugal,
Oman.
Taiwan, 2 times Oman.
With this bike?
And with this bike. I try to use the bike pack in the middle. But it's not for me, because I touch with my leg. So I have to change a little bit in here, and this is perfect. In front of, I use this one for to put all the power banking, for to recharge the GPS, recharge the phone. Fortunately, I use too much phone when I cycling, and the GPS, the power bank is gonna be too empty, because I love to take photo, video, and but it's too much. So this time I have to stop to buy another power bank, but it wasn't enough, because my GPS is turn off 6K before the final line.
So you might need later a dynamo.
Yeah, I think
that might be the next
time,
improvement.
will be the right solution. This is the power for the battery for the light, because my light is very powerful, because for me the safety in the distance during the night is the first rule number one. I wanted to see my road, I don't want to take a very light or very small light for to save the kilo, the some grams. No, I don't want. I wanted to put all maximum for to view perfect.
So that's a Lupin. What's the power?
More than 5,000 lumen.
5,000.
Yes.
Wow.
In the here, I use this pocket for to put all my not all my food, but part of my food. As you see, this is the garbage, because we are cyclists and we respect our environment, and we don't put through away, but we put everything in my cycle. This I use for cycling kind of different kind of bars, because I wanted to test different during the race. Don't want to eat the same things, because after 2 days it's gonna be very problem to eat the bars.
So you only ate food that you carry, or you bought some food on the way as well?
I bought food here. Okay, this is when I start, it's full of food.
Okay.
Then I use this one. It's a 9 liter.
Okay.
It's 9 liter, no more. And I put the clothes, lots clothes this way, because we are in a high mountain. And more bar
food.
And more food, like gels and wherever. I don't use, this.
So you still have some spare food after 1,000 kilometers?
Yes, I do that. Yes, because after 2 days I'm not able to eat gels and whatever, so I have to stop to eat ice cream, Coca-Cola and pizza. But
pizza?
Yeah, pizza. I'm stopped for 3 times eat pizza.
Okay.
But
like a big pizza, an entire piece.
Entire piece.
Okay.
I threw away a little bit of mozzarella, you know, so it's too much heavy. But yes. And but you have to always, we have to, just in case of emergency, you have to have the
survival
the
snack. Yeah?
Survival, yeah, for sure. Then I have all equipment, all clothes for the winter, because I'm expected in a high mountain the weather gonna be to change quickly, and I wanted to save my body, I want to save myself, just in case. I have long pants for raining, the cover shoes, and then yeah, this is arms.
Arm warmers,
I use it. And this is pretty heavy, but it's essential. This is for repair the tube.
Okay.
Just in case.
Because you're running tubeless now.
Yeah, I run in tubeless. I'm feeling really bad in tubeless. Then I have very important things is a blanket.
The survival blanket.
The survival blanket, very important things. And 4 battery. For our GPS, just
the
in case, and spot, yes. Then I have a most part, and this is easy, pretty heavy, but it's the tools.
The multi-tool.
Yeah. I talking with a guy, there is also the in titanium. This is not titanium, this is steel.
Okay.
And
so that's
most
the mandatory
part.
Kit for
yeah,
repairing.
Kit, yes. And the more and the most important for me, I think.
Show us your secret.
This is
the cleats.
The cleats, because just in case you rope, you broke your cleats, you have finished your competition. You can able to keep going.
So you're
because
riding
what
the
happened,
road
maybe
kits, huh?
Maybe you have to. The clips is plastic, so happen to. It's not very complicated to broke. Could be happen, and this is.
So in case you're using road cleats.
Road cleats. I use
why
road
don't
cleats.
You use mountain bike cleats?
Because good question. I don't know why I don't use because I used to be the road and so that's it, because I used to be. This is not a special reason.
When you were riding as a pro, you were using this?
This, yes.
Road kits only?
Yes.
Okay, so it's a matter of...
But
do you
know,
if
I have also the Farah gravel bike, and I use for sure the clips for mountain bike.
Okay. Okay, so...
Then 2 bundles and a spare tube.
Okay, in the back, yeah.
In the back. 2 light. Red light.
Okay. In the back to be visible.
In the back visible, yes. And I use the SRAM, red SRAM, 33 in the back.
Okay, so 1 gear ratio between the front and the back.
Yes. 46 in the front, 33, and 10, 33.
And electric?
Electric.
Okay.
And absolutely disc. Disc brake is no,
it's a must,
no
huh?
Other question.
No question about these
no,
brakes.
No.
Okay. What about the wheels?
The wheels is American company wheels. Is it's very very comfortable in distance and in the flat. Is maybe for the climb is not the maximum that I expected, but my strategy in ultra cycling is go slowly in the climb and go a little bit fast in the distance and the flat, because the effort you put in the climb is not is too much for to reduce your time, so you have to put more stronger in flat and the distance.
Okay,
in a climb
strategy.
You have to go slowly.
Okay,
so you spend too much energy and for nothing.
You've been riding with the bars as well, aero bars?
Yeah, always time, always, always? Time. I'm feeling really good because I change, always time I change position. Uh-huh. And more when I find the flat road, I understand that I'm faster than 2-3 km for hour.
Okay.
Just if you put more in the modality aerial.
Okay.
So I'm feel good. I know it's 300 gram or more, 350, but it's not.
It's worth it.
It's worth it. Yes.
Okay. And what's your secret item? Something that you carry all the time and that is not mandatory. Do you have any secret item that you bring with you? Anything special or that is not in the mandatory kit of the biking man?
Nothing special. My clips for because I'm my mentality. Oh, if I rip my clips, I don't can keep going. No, nothing special. That is, I show you is that
is essential.
Yes, it's essential.
Eh ben, merci, Christian. Merci beaucoup. Thank you. One advice for people willing to join Biking Man X. What would be your first advice?
My first advice is start steady. Continue steady and finish steady. Stop. And I enjoy because it was been really a fantastic roads and a fantastic experience. And I invited everyone that has courage to do the bike man.
So it's like Jacques Barge. You remember Jacques?
I remember.
What you're saying is faut gérer.
Faut gérer.
Faut gérer in French. Like you need to go steady all the time.
Yes.
Et le même conseil, the same advice.
Thank you very much, Christian. And we'll see you hopefully on another Biking Man.
Okay, see you.
Bye, ciao.